I am Eliane Rodriguez. I'm concert pianist. I'm giving already around 20 years lessons at the Conservatoire from Antwerp. But before this, when I came here after a few years, I also gave lessons in the Music Academy from Antwerp, 2-3 music academies, Weinigem and also here in the Mago, for children and then also amateur people. And I like it very much. I just stopped it there because I could not fit all the concerts from me and the conservatory and everything together. It was not possible. But I like it very much to give also lessons for young people and also for amateur people. That is as important as walking. You cannot walk going without, you must give weight in two legs, otherwise you cannot go. Let's say just the same. It's vital. That you, let's say that weight technique doesn't mean that you need to, very stupid thing. For example, okay, you walk. You don't go like this. You don't walk like this. You walk with you. Still, you put your pillows in every leg you are going to walk. The same on the piano. You put also the weight on the note without making ping, boom, ping. That is just the same. It's how the weight is something will make you rest, to be quiet, that you can respire, that you can listen. And also, because the muscles, they need to have a point where the other muscle is going to begin to work. There are two muscles. One is making this and the other one is making this. And they change with each other. They need to go somewhere where they can rest to that the other one takes. Like a you put a fire in the hand of the other one, like this. First of all, there is a big difference when you start with someone very young. And when you start with someone when they have already come inside of a conservatory, then they need to make a prestation, that they need to have a kind of ends after 2 months or 3 months or 4 months. That you cannot expect that you can make all this work in 1 or 2 months. Let's say you need to make in phase, you know? You start to talk about it and you try out things. And you see how they react. Depending of the reaction of the student, you go on quicker or slower. And you must adapt your music. I think that is interesting when you work with the student, also pieces like with variations. Let's say that with the variations, certainly the first, second year, you can work many sides of the technique. Legato, staccato, how you make things. I think it's very important. Yeah, and depends a lot of the person. There are also the level who they are coming. It is, and also I think that every person is like a river. There are deeper river and there are smaller river. And there are river, when you must, your part of the of your job is to fill the river from someone. You may not be angry if someone has a small river. You understand, this is, thank God that everybody is different one of the other. Let's say, if someone has a small river, there you work. If someone has such a river, there you work. And the boat, they have the right to exist. You understand? And this that you must constantly start to feel. You need to feel this thing, because this is your duty as a professor, is not to put someone with a small river, being via such a river, because he will be not happy. And you need to feel happy from what am I, in fact? Both rivers are very beautiful. This is very important to give respect and attention for the both types. Yes, maybe I use all the cards I have. depending from the person, because, for example, also a question from taste, and that sometimes a personality don't want to play the God because it doesn't like. Mm-hmm. You understand? You may not also force a person like something. You must go through the road of the person. But if the person, let's say, of course, you is also a question of the muscles, because there are persons who the muscles doesn't permit play legato because student got this equilibrium from one leg to the other. Going, we have five legs, and that you must go from one to the other. You need to have a kind of confidence on your own leg. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And if you don't have this, and you prefer to go tick 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 tick, you cannot also go against this. But you must find an equilibrium outside of your body that compensate this legato. Understand?
Mm-hmm. Can you give an example on the piano? Or?
Yeah, fun. Most of the time I play legato, no? But how can I make an example? Let's think. For example, something very that everybody start study from Bach. Bach played the fugue. That's very legato. What is legato? I'm going here. And I'm going there, and then this foot is going away, and it's like you go to the fitness. You have one foot here and the other there, and then this one still down, and you put this one, and then this one is going up, and then afterwards you go this down, and then this one is going up. This later, little bit like a lazy foot, yeah. And the other one will play a little bit like an organ. Both can, you understand? But you must feel good. Mm-hmm. You must feel good on this where you really believe.
Okay, and what if the piece they are playing is Rachmaninoff, or, you know, some post-romantic thing that they need to be like legato, legatissimo?
Yeah, but I think this is a kind of, how can I say? This is development. It just comes, because when you make, for example, without pedal,
really play staccato, and they have to play some
melody. They will find also their legato.
Okay, okay.
Yes.
But I think you said that you made them listen, you know.
Yes.
So they like the sound, and
yes,
they try to do it.
Yes. Certainly start with the hand apart. I don't put the two hands to. They play two hands, and then I say, no, let's try first the left hand, and afterwards the right hand. And then they begin to realize at that moment. Normally, I don't like very much to play against the piano. Let's say this, I find a little bit aggressive. I think that you push the piano away. I don't like very much the sound. I wish, or I do like this, or otherwise I put my hand. Now, when you listen a real thing. You really, you have this kind of rotation, this is true. And you make a very small movement with the finger. Why? Because with the pole, with the rotation, you feel the time. The time that you go to the next one. And also, not making too much finger, this hammer doesn't go with the same speed. Everything in life is a question of taste, because when you make a accompaniment with many notes, depending from what it is, if of course it's an arpeggio, you don't need a lot of fingers. You don't need a lot of fingers. But if there are many things, how can I say?
Stay like
finger, this thin note, this your hand must go like this. The person who really did a lot of such a thing was Chopin. In all his pieces, you learn a lot with Chopin. Chopin was really the essence for such a thing. In fact, you will speak about the bowing of the piece, the bowing, this is the phrasing. Yeah, of course, I'm going out from the bowing that the composer has written. Most of the composer, they give a red, very clear tip what he would like to listen. I was just giving lesson now from Rachmaninoff, Prelude on 23, number 5, song in the, and then you have the. For example, when you came in the slow moment, I think now there's a specific in chords. Because in a chord, most of the time you are going to choose one finger in the chord who you are going to make more legato than others. Mm-hmm. The other one would say, your pulse is going from one accord to the other in per note, and then wait. And then what you were telling about was the melody, and the melody that is something else. This I shall start most of the time down on the first finger. You go to the first finger, the first note, and then you go up to the other note. Because where you first of all try to find where is your first finger. And where would you can combine with what is written. That's if you put a first finger somewhere just in the middle of a sentence, this you break a little bit. Let's say try to avoid the first finger, because the first finger, most of the time you go down. Let's say try to make that the other fingers make until comes the first finger again down on the right, on the real time, the right time.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say the fingering should be together with the bowing, let's say. But the first finger is always the first of the bowing. There you go very naturally down.
For example, in that little fragment you play,
yeah.
If the student is playing like tan tan ta ta,
yeah, tan tan ta ta,
how did you help them realize that that is not correct?
Like this.
Yes, and how do they work?
Yes, first of all, I will say for them to avoid accent. First of all, and now this specific moment, you really need to make a pulse per note because you must go down, but you must avoid then accent on the longer note, because when you make it like this. Doors, you know, and you in fact you must go into this one, because there is your door that you're gonna don't put accent here. And I put there because it's like you said that people don't realize immediately that they stay stiff and they stay there making the note without going outside and put your finger again in the next note. They say most of the time I take the hand of them and I put the pulse and I put there. Then they there I must go out. Then they start to realize.
Uh-huh.
I do many times physically. I take them with the hand.
Mm-hmm.
Many times. Yeah.
Okay.
Now, speaking about technique, from my 4 to my 9 years old, I played very articulated. She learned me how to play very articulated. But the thing is that making this articulation, I start to have kind of balls, everywhere balls. So, there was nothing, it became crispated. Mm-hmm. Then, with 9 years old, I was starting study with someone else. This person said to me, said to my mother, she must stop completely everything. Everything I played. I played already Haydn concert, I played Mozart concert, I played Prelude von Bach, I played Sonata of Two Number One from Beethoven. I played many things. Sonata I played with 5 years old. Okay, I stopped it. Then he said, now she's going to start again. Everything from Do Re Mi Fa Sol with a method from Alfred Cortot. He used there at that moment. And I think this man saved me because I was a very, very tiny little girl. And everything was very fragile. And playing the whole time like this, I didn't have no one place to rest. Like you said about legato, I started to really to think about, I felt. Like a child, you feel. You don't think, you feel better. And I think something was very good with me is people didn't start too much speak about theory. You must, with a child, you must not start with too much theory. You must just go to the point. You say to a child like this, listen, if you see that the child make like this with his hand, you just say, listen, this finger, you didn't ask to play, just put down. Did you ask this one? No, put down. Which finger must play? The fourth, and it's the fourth who is going there to play. Just say like this, they understand that is the language they want to listen is a very practical language. Now, what I started to play like this. And what my teacher, many times he had the patience to, sometimes he put my arm, he said, yes, now, again. And again. And again. And then you stay there. And feel the same. And then you begin. Let's say, go to here. And then begin. Go to there. You understand? Don't be afraid the place you are going. Go there and start there. You understand? Put your hand here. Put your hand there. Put your hand here. And put your hand there. You understand? That you start to understand this. This is what you need. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Then, the first exercise was this. And then afterwards, and normally when I was small, many times I did this with a finger. And my teacher said to me, are you looking toward the platform? No, don't put it there again. Okay. And such a thing make a child understand. Okay, now, I need to study like this more than 1 year. A child don't ask themselves, oh, I didn't play the piece. I just play technique. People don't think about this. A child think about it. My teacher said to me, do like this. I do this. Then you look to the wall, you look to outside, you look to your grandmother, and this becomes a part of you. Doesn't become an outside part. This must come inside of you because it's a way to walk. Walk on the piano. As you walk, you also learn how to walk on the street, and afterwards you first learn how to walk with your mother and father, afterwards you start to walk, become right. The same on the piano. And then afterwards, the second exercise he asked me was to play. First, I put my weight, I put my weight in one finger, and then afterwards I need to do. And then the next one, stay there. Feel all free, I am there. And then you do. There's such a thing you do with one hand, you do with two hands. And then you put out, you pose up, and then. He also understood me how to make a scale. A scale is a. like you make a drawing. You draw a line and you come back. You go and you come back. It's not a line, like, it's not this. No, it's, you understand, you continue. Let's say, what I have already many experiences in this sense that the children, they like very much fly. Let's say, then I say to the child that he must kind of feeling that without sound, and begin to sound. And you are flying much more kilometers than you think that you need to make this to fly this kilometer. You understand? The same on the piano. Mm-hmm. Certainly, I should try to young people never take pieces or their hand need to do this. Mm-hmm. Take pieces with the hand to be more in the fifth, 1, 2, 5 or 1, 2, 6, but not too much, you know, because the person has the tendency to do like this, and then you become stiff, and then you don't, then you are disorganized.
Mm-hmm. And how do you work? Do you work with exercises or outside the piano or in the piano that help? Then you know, like have like a firm.
Listen, part? I don't do this because unfortunately, we don't have the time to do this. But my teacher has made with me. At that moment, when I was young, the hours that we expend with students were longer than now on times. Unfortunately, I find this very sad because when I think about, for example, ballet, they have maybe 8, 9, 10, self, even 12 hours lessons per week. We have one lesson per week with the student, and that is it. And you need to solve. And for young people, maybe 20 minutes, let's see, this is really unhappy. But what my teacher has learned me many times was on the wall. Because my teacher in Brazil, I was, he learned me how to, he learned me to, that I need to make exercise going like this with my hand and then stay with two fingers, with two. Three fingers, and then with one hand, and then with another hand, you know, to, but I don't know if it's, he made this. I could never do here in my student, but he said that you need to know how to stay with, that your hand can keep your finger, can keep your that you go, to everywhere, but I don't know if this was the made result because I was too young. I don't know, but I know that I need to do this from him.
If you detect in a way that you have a student who, when he tried to play, he had like a soft hand.
Yes, depends a lot because you know. I cannot imagine that the only way playing the piano must be a hand who is perfect. Mm-hmm. I think the most important thing in life is how to manage your own body and your own hand and make it perfect on your way. Because I don't believe that if now with the in the practical side of the life today, with the hours we have, if we only think that the only person who must be everything perfect, it's impossible. It's impossible because the perfection you make met with what you have. You know, in Brazil was someone who was a very known sculptor. And he made all the sculpture in a very important city from my country. And he had lepra. And he made everything with the foot, with the hand, and this is my way to think. I don't believe that you only can play in one way. You need to produce the sound you want from your way. You understand? Let's say, in principle, of course, it's very good, because when you put your hand like this, you have automatically a sound which will be easier to make a beautiful sound. But in the other side, if you have a hand who don't have this trained at that moment, and you start to do this, you are going to crispate everything, and also your neck, and also your arm, and for to get this very specific point. Also you become crazy, because you don't, you only think about this. Let's say, even you don't enjoy any other music, and at the end you do the piano grooves, and that is not the, it's not this the result. You must be able to see through things. You can try, if you see that the person becomes, in fact, to be happy, to back to develop, then you must make other things. Let's say, in this sense, I shall say, try to keep longer the high note and make shorter the note who is under. This gives also a very interesting sound. And based on this sound, you can make a whole word. You understand? You don't need to do always like everybody expects from it. You just make on your own way. And just say, life is short, and I'm very happy to do this. I shall start, for example, with the basso, because we have even made it like this. I shall start anyway with Scarlatti sonatas. It's something who is very interesting, very beautiful, gives a lot of it's a lot of charm, romantic, brilliant, kind. There are so many variations, not too long, and you can study many kind of sound together with the prelude and fugues, because prelude and fugue van Bach was also thought about studies in this time. The prelude and fugue that Bach did was just like studies for that moment, is why he put things here and put things there. Because you put it here and you put it there. And it's also for to be able to be independent.
Mm-hmm. But it's, I think it's interesting that the piece you choose are Baroque, you know, because usually we don't identify Baroque, no, with weight and neck and legato.
Yes. No, but you may be sure that they also used these things.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think that we are different. I don't think that Baroque was different from now.
Mm-hmm.
Baroque was also romantic. Baroque was also legato. Baroque was, you understand what I say? Because people is just people. And once they must make something dramatic, they did on their way. When I listen people who are all the Baroque people who plays around here, is this one who make the most rubat. Why? Because it's romantic. And people say, oh, I mean, I don't know. You understand? You must see, of course, every instrument reacts different. But these pieces makes you become strong with your own roots. Is very important. You can imagine that you don't have your roots.
But for example, what do you think of people who say that from the classicism, the Bach, you know, like Baroque and classicism, should be played only with the fingers? What do you think?
Yeah, but this is the thing. You can play only with the fingers, but you can also be coherent playing legato. But of course, making this exercise with the finger is not bad. You understand what I say? You need to have your fingers because it's like small soldiers that need to run, and they must be together with you. You understand? That I say that when you make some exercise with your finger, doesn't mean that the other one doesn't matter. Matter, yes. And there you, that is the way that you must, in fact, take a piece who is more legato and another one who is more finger, because it's not all the pieces who are non legato, it's not all who is with legato, you understand?
And when you are having like a beginner student, do you work only fingers first and then you apply weight, or do you start with everything? How do you
for just children, mm-hmm. I shall work everything legato.
Mm-hmm.
Or with weight, let's say, let your hand rest on the piano and try something from there. Huh? For example, I say something. Someone, but you must know how to make a lipstick. You cannot go, you understand, you need to know how to make this. And you put when you want, and if you don't want, you don't. But you need to know. And this you start from the beginning. And then you have. I think that. Every person who make physically things need to make exercise.
With me?
Physical things. Let's say you have a football, you have a tennis player, you have a swimmer. And they all make an exercise. Why we may not have?
Mm-hmm.
I think it's not bad.
Mm-hmm.
But the exercise must be in good doses, not so much that you don't listen anymore. You understand? The exercise is in function from something. don't make things too loud. Don't make something who you don't, you, when you lose your attention, you don't exercise anymore. You only exercise when your attention is there. That is, it's better to make a small exercise, or maybe in between the pieces, make a kind of exercise on the piece, man, saying, you understand? Than to make so much exercise that you don't, you are not anymore aware from what you are doing. You see, but exercise, everybody did. It's a difficult question, but I think that what I just have said earlier, every person plays in their own possible level. Yeah? The first thing is to see how is this person? Is a person which kind of talent he has or she has? Is this quickly fingers or is there more cantabile? And then I try to start to have a kind of architecture who is in function from her possibility can be acceptable. Understand? And I can see about the quick how quick it must be. Can be, for example, if a person has a very small hand, sometimes I must make kind of adaptations that maybe you take with the right hand or maybe even instead of 10 notes, I take down an octave and then I take the next note to the next chord, that if this takes sense, it makes coherence. And say, I will work my maximum to see that this is this building is strong, made through the for this person, you understand? I think this is our duty, because at any way, you cannot make a metamorphose in someone. There are people with 2 meters, and the other one is 1.75 meters. The other one, and the thing first of all is to know the person, and see what the strong side, and the less strong side, and make an architecture made for that person who makes sense with the composition, because anyway the composition must be the function in function from this composition. Let's say I think I will be like I make like this, and then try to really make in small rooms that the person start to feel at home, from this room to the next room, and then afterwards I work the gangs, the small gang, and mm-hmm. Then I think I will be like this. I can only say a good teacher must have a lot of experience in many music. There's many styles. You must be interested to listen also new pieces, new style. He must not keep himself short. He must be able to listen and confront himself very eagerly with other things. And when he listens, when he is going to see for the first person, he must really always think about that it's not him who is going to play, it's the person who is going to play. And he is there to put the person to walk through their foot, you understand? He may not make this person a kind of portrait from himself. He must make the person identify the portrait of the composer through themselves. Let's say, through their own possibility and capacity, you must motivate the person to listen to concert, motivate the person to culturally be be aware, listen to people, listen to YouTube, listen to concerts, listen to operas, listen to everything, that the person has so many input. And little by little, let this person try out things with their hand, with their time. And what you must be the coach. The coach to see if this person is really make something coherent in function from the piece she is making. Let's say, the choice that this person makes, is this an intelligent choice at that moment? But first of all, you must see that maybe the most difficult study in life is music. Because you put a person just naked in front of a jury, and the jury must give a point. And this is the most difficult you do for someone. Let's say, first of all, you must give so much strong, be there together, and also let understand that this is part of the human being. This, you are there making, you are the portparol from the piece. You are telling, you are defending, you are telling for someone else the piece. And when a person receives a point, it's not against the person, but sometimes the person it was not very clear and people could not understand. And also, the person must also understand that not everybody are ready to listen new things. Sometimes people need time, you know? For example, when Gershwin has made his Rhapsody in Blue and his concert, people didn't like so much on that moment. This doesn't mean that what he did was wrong, but need time for people to understand, for people to become used, you understand? That is, let's say you must believe, after you have studied something, you must believe, okay, this is right. It's in function from what they compose, I see. Thus, you must also understand that it's not always that the person at once accepts something new, that person didn't, for example, listen something slower or quicker. You are not used. Thus, you come too quick, and then people react. They say, a point is not only based in the right, not like a mathematics. It's based on reaction. Reacts from what you see and what you listen. And people are very much reacting also from what he sees. If, for example, a person has more stiff fingers, people think already immediately that the person is stiff, but it's not always. It's just her body, who doesn't know very well how to have the right combination. You understand? But this gives an image. And this person, the jury, then react there inside. This is also very human. They say, don't go, just give a lot of mood. And, you know, I don't know if you understand the mood, that the student don't stay sad. That they just go on. Because it's what's very important is that a person must know that she is learning continually. When you make one concert, that is the one from many others, the first from many other experience. Nobody's perfect. Everybody makes fault. And everybody walking learn more. Let's say, and you must be there to see to them critically what was better, what was less good for the next time, but not putting this person down, because if you put the person down, then it's lost. Then I think this is a very important thing for a teacher, is not put people lost. Yes. And also a big palette from many style, because this is also very important. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Playing real very good the piano is not so important. What you must know is how to transmit the right thing. Because it's not always that because you play very well the piano, you are a very well good teacher. There are people who simply are too introvert and don't don't put, because it's too much emotion, and this person stays there and cannot make this, but can be very good teachers. Let's say one has the experience is very important. Experience in style, experience to how to tell people, to show people is very important. Maybe even more important than always it's not always the greatest pianist is the greatest teacher of the world. That depends a lot.